This is in conflict with the UK's policy, HESWALL DRIVE. Thank you.
Thanks, Samantha. Any questions of clarification?
Okay.
Thank you. Okay, members.
Separation distances relate to habitable rooms, so where two habitable rooms overlook each other or look onto each other, we would expect a minimum distance of 21 metres to be achieved. So there are no habitable room windows, so those distances don't apply here.
Beyond the
walkout
of the
bakery,
there are a number of challenges to our own policy.
Supplementary planning document 2, which was written and approved by council back in 2007. So, as we've discussed at committee before, there have been changes in national policy with the introduction of the national planning policy framework in 2012. So, the report quite rightly reflects on SPD2. And highlights areas of concern, but it also has weighed into the recommendation other matters, particularly national planning policy framework, and changes to policy that have occurred since then, which we feel outweigh both those areas.
That's that.
This site is contained wholly in the primarily residential area. On the opposite side of OLDFIELD DRIVE, we have green belt. So the purpose of the green belt is to avoid, as you say, creep and things like that. And each application is considered on its own merits. So this application has been looked at, having regard to the individual merits of this scheme and this site. Hence the recommendation for approval. That's not to say that an application further down Belfield Drive would be acceptable. We would have to look at the merits of that application as well.
Any thanks, Master. Having heard some of the comments that have been given already, I am concerned that this is, if you like, a gateway into Heswell. As Matthew has already said, it is on the verge, it's as close as you can get to Green World without being clearly, we know why the applications come in. It's a very lucrative site, no doubt. But I think the policy that Matthew referred to, I think it's SPD2 in terms of new craft developments, I don't think we've given enough weight to that policy. I'm not disrespecting the officers of opinion, I'm just simply saying that I don't think enough weight is particular policy, which has been adopted with good reason. And I think from this particular development, we know that this end of Telegraph Road, because it's on the edge of the Greenbelt, is by its virtue, it's not going to be close to services or facilities that are accessible by a number of means of transport, as opposed to simply going around in a car, to answer the points that were raised on the previous application. So I would personally be minded to refuse this application with a view to giving greater weight to SPD 2, and I would move that after comments from the other members.
Yeah, thanks. I just want to clarify the point that I think Councillor Hodson and Councillor Gardner both seem to be concerned that if this application is approved, then it will mean that further flats will start appealing down the road. As I understand it, we can only deal with this application as it is. And if in the future other applications come in, they'll be treated at that time. So I think what I'm saying is it correct that we couldn't mind to refuse this application on the grounds that we're concerned that further ones might come in later? Is that correct?
Yes, thank you. Through you, Chair, as I explained in response to Councillor Gardner's question, that's why each application is considered on its individual merits. So if this is approved, it wouldn't necessarily follow that something else I know of you would like to be approved as well.
For you, Chair, you could, of course, look at a cumulative effect, though, couldn't you? That if there is a predominance, whilst you look at every application on its individual merits, there comes a point where there's a cumulative effect. So that cumulative effect may at some point be the tipping point between approving or not approving an individual application.
Further comments? Any further comments? Anybody wish to put a proposal?
Yeah, I'd like to move refusal. With regards to application number 00167 for OLDFIELD DRIVE, HESWALL, I would move that the application is contrary to the objective listed as 2.9 of SPD 2, in so much as the location of the new flat developments. For self-contained flats, should be in locations that are close to services and facilities and that are accessible by close to the means of transport. The proposal would also be of a bearing to number 295 Telegraph Road, and it would be in conflict with policy HS4 Part 1, which requires proposals to be of a scale which relates well to surrounding property in particular with regard to existing densities and form of development in the area. And I have had the right to give that up.
Is that seconded? Any further comments? Happy to vote. Let's see those in favour of that refusal. And those against? Any abstentions? That refusal is lost. Any further proposals?
Right. I'm happy to move, Chair, that the application be approved.
Okay, is that seconded? Can see those in favour of that proposal. And those against?
Two additional dwellings, but plot two on the east of the site is now been deleted from the scheme.
Roselands is a large characterful property set within its own grounds. The overall site measures 0.75 hectares. The site will be subdivided with the block for Roselands being reduced to 0.53 hectares and a new dwelling will be built in a new block measuring 0.22 hectares to the west of the existing house. Access will be via a new driveway from Croft Drive located on the southern boundary of the site. The new house would be 8 metres high to the ridge and would measure 16.3 metres wide and 8.7 metres deep. It would be located 12 metres from the side elevation of Roselands. There are no habitable room windows in either of the side elevations of the existing dwelling or the proposed new dwelling, and therefore this distance is acceptable. The new dwelling is 16 metres from 17 Croft Drive to west. And again, there are no habitable room windows on the side elevation of either property that will be affected by the proposed development. There is also substantial ground treatment along the western boundary of the site, much of which will be retained. The dwelling would sit 50 metres back within the site from Croft Drive. The application site is located within Cardi Conservation Area, and the proposed new dwelling has been sensitively designed to reflect this, mirroring some of the characteristics of the house dwelling that is to be retained. There is a qualifying petition.
The representative of the petitioners, Mr. Professors. Please go
forward. Good evening.
Good evening. Turn your mic on, there's a button with a face on it. Good evening. If you could give us your name and tell us who you represent, and we will have 5 minutes.
Caroline Evans and I represent the Caldy residents. I chair the Caldy Society, which is the local residents association. Thank you for allowing me to speak about this application. I know you've all been sent letters of objection and the petition that was sent to you as well, so I won't waste your time going through that. But I will make a few brief and important points about this application. As you've already said, Roselands is a beautiful Edwardian house in its own grounds. It's an important example of Edwardian architecture in the area. In fact, it's so important that it has been put on a proposed local list of buildings of architectural interest. As you say, it's set centrally in grounds of less than 2 acres, and this setting limits the options for the new buildings proposed. As you who intended the site visit, which you've seen for yourselves, and the proposed building is set at the side. This is a large proposal, the house proposed is very large, and it's actually, to my mind, squashed.